I'm going home with the suit. Let's be clear. I'm definitely going home with the suit.
My plan is just to wear it on the last day and then just not take it off.
What are they gonna do? Fire me?
The pilot. I remember the amount of secrecy that went into the superhero suit. I just remember even being on stages, walking around with like four coats on over top of the costume.
What I remember most about the pilot, honestly, is Steven's abs. It's the truth.
Go.
It's the truth. I remember thinking to myself, I'm supposed to be this dude's bodyguard. I need to hit the gym, honestly. That's what I was thinking.
If you rewatch the pilot, I have food in my teeth in the party scene. And so what I can also tell you is that bumps me anytime I see that.
I remember learning the fight sequences because all the action pieces were built and designed by the time I got up to Vancouver, like a month before we started filming. And I didn't have a huge amount of experience doing stunts. Just remember your first day, camera tests, first time you get to wear the suit, all that good stuff.
As we got into the pilot, I remember feeling like, you know, we might, you know, I didn't dare let myself think, right, that we have something really special. But the more we got into the pilot, David Nutter, our director, he, for whatever reason, knew. And everyone else was like, "Shh, don't say that. Don't say that this is gonna be successful. We don't wanna jinx it." But everyone had the feeling that we stumbled upon something.
But that same day, we shot the scene up in the hallway with Oliver and I, just the two of us, and we have this conversation. I remember David Nutter coming up to Steven and I and like grabbing both of our hands and looking at us genuinely and literally said, "Both of you, like, you were born to play Laurel Lance, and you were born to play Oliver Queen, and you guys just, this is gonna be a family that you have and can cherish forever." So, and for a director to say that, especially with the pilot, you know, I mean, it's David Nutter, though, like, so it was really moving and touching, and, you know, we just grew as a family.
It's a challenging year for me because it seems like every episode I'm seeing someone again for the first time in a long time, but at the same time, then I have to say goodbye to them again. It's tough. I've done the whole hi and bye with Colin Donnell, with Ryo Fukushima, with Willa Holland, David Nickel, Paul Blackthorne, Byron Mann. It's crazy.
I'm gonna be honest, like, it hasn't hit me just yet. Like, I think we're all just kind of like, we know it, it's there, and we're just trying to not ignore it, but kind of put it on pause a little bit, just until that, maybe that very last day or that day before when we're all done, and then, and that's it. And that's just, I don't know, now that I think about it, I'm like, whoa, that's crazy.
But there's also, you know, we won't be working together anymore. Like any other job, you'll miss the people you work with.
I hope the legacy of the show is something that spawned a universe, the Arrowverse. You know, hopefully the legacy will show that we got great content like Flash and Supergirl and Legends of Tomorrow, now Batwoman, and who knows where that'll keep going, right? What other characters we'll be able to, you know, create and spin off and bring to life. I feel like Arrow's done a great job of just kind of opening the vault of DC.
The time and the experiences over the years, you know, those are the memories that I will forever cherish and have. And they become your family.
I hope that we were lucky to be first, but it seems like retrospectively, I think it has been a really, really cool stretch of time for superhero shows on TV. And, you know, the very fact that it has spawned something called the Arrowverse, I think is pretty exciting.